wanted to ask you, so from like a winery perspective, like grapes become an issue at some point, right? There's only so much land, and so you have to harvest, or you have to buy grapes from other farmers in the area. I imagine it's the same for you guys, but maybe in, I don't know where you guys grow, if it's Jalisco or other places, but is it an issue where you're running into that now? Sort of
100%.
Like,
that's why agave prices are sky high right now. I think the last time I checked, it was about 30 pesos a kilo. And those agave, the piñas can get really heavy, but yeah, there's a shortage right now. And okay, that's why agave prices are so high. So with the growth of tequila and with the shortage of agave, that, yeah, there's always fear, but at the same time, you see it every 10 years. And I feel like, I know that it's a lot of the times it's the bigger brands mass producing, mm-hmm, and just kind of storing it, because you could produce a blanco and store it or dump it into barrels. So okay, a lot of the big hitters, to kind of like siphon out the little guys, they'll mass produce to create a shortage of agave and increase the price of agave.
I know this is the problem. Like this is actually a really interesting issue. I know there's a tremendous amount of legislation that a lot of these massive distillers have passed to make it impossible for a little guy to exist. We were looking at building a distillery in Houston with a buddy of mine. He ended up doing it. And I got kind of familiar with all the legislation that exists, and it's crazy. It's like, if I go into production, I have to start at this amount. And so let's call it t-shirts. It's like, it's not buying 100 t-shirts. You got to go from zero to 10,000 t-shirts, which is an insane amount to a new company.
It's sad, but true. It's the same thing. So CRT, Consejo Regulador de Tequila, they control and they govern anything tequila. Okay. So there's been a bunch of regulations and changes. So the little guys have to produce X amount of liters a year, which some of them, for these little guys, it's impossible. Like the numbers that they're asking for, it's close to, it's just impossible for them to be able to keep their nom, which is a number that every distillery has that allows them to call their product tequila. So what you're seeing nowadays, a lot of these small distilleries that can't meet that demand, they let their nom go because they just can't, like they can't afford it. And instead of calling it tequila, they're calling it a distillate of agave instead of a tequila. And that's kind of what the big hitters are doing to kind of siphon out all the little guys.
Yeah, it's crazy. It honestly, like when I was getting into this, I was like, this is a racket and a half.